Sedona State Forest, Memorial Day weekend. The birds for neighbors. Clayton, New York. Thank you.
framed leather, hand-painted, placed throughout the castle in case of a fire. Castle was heated by steam heat. The radiators have been removed. 1995, the castle broke. Dr. Martin was well known for not getting an employee. And the caretaker left and the crooks split it all free. The only way to do it is rip up the door tomorrow. All right, we're making our way up the stairs. Passageways were used by the servant. They were required to stay quiet and help out of sight. There was a radiator for the air.
Singer sewing machines. Look at that.
In this room, the call buttons are on either side of the table. There's a button. And you can check out the nice lights on the table.
Well, hide away.
Take that tour.
You do not have to push those buttons for a servant. There is a vent in the spiral staircase up there. A servant would stand at that vent, watching over the table. It is said he or she would know what you wanted and needed and send it to you before you asked. Huh. I get that if you know the people. But if they're strangers, you're not going to know what to send to them. This is a black marble fireplace, hand-carved, imported from Italy. 90 stonemasons came from Italy for construction of the castle. You're going to Bolt Castle next. Has anyone been to Bolt Castle before? Okay. George Bolt was building Bolt Castle at the same time Frederick was building this. All the granite came from Oak Island, which is across from us. For here and for Bolt Castle, two different stone cutters. These are random shapes. Bolt Castles are all square and rectangular. Now, George Bolt's wife died. He abandoned the castle, and all of his workers came here. There was over 300 men working here in around-the-clock shifts. It took less than 2 years to complete this castle and surrounding buildings. Everybody know who Frederick Remington is? World-famous artist, sculptor. This is Buster Bracco on loan to us from the Remington Art Museum. Frederick Remington had a cottage and studio on Tamaki Island across from us. He was there during the construction years and complained constantly about the noise. The sound travels really good on the river. However, he did send the family a bouquet of flowers and a letter welcoming them to the neighborhood when they first arrived. You can pull that set of doors right towards you, and we'll go into the breakfast room. Neither one could be president as long as the other was alive. Clark hired Frederick, which was a smart move because Frederick took Singer worldwide. Frederick Bourne had nothing to do with Singer. Singer was a scoundrel, 13 mistresses and 27 children with them. As I was saying up front, Frederick was a minister's son. He's highly religious. He never had anything to do with him, and that's why his family members think the name Singer should be gone. All right, this is the oldest antique in the castle. It is a refractor table. Both sides. only rail car train. You'll notice there's some games in all of them. I put those there for my overnight guests. Going back the other way here is the passageway door, and into the dining room we would go. We close doors so we don't listen to each other. Now, we have moose, elk, caribou, white tail here. Spiral staircase. Remember the vent in the dining room? Six steps higher, you can step out of that spiral staircase and walk around this room inside the walls above the windows. Completely around it. There is a picture of the fictional King Charles up here above the center window. It tilts back. Behind me is a passageway door. Three ways to open it. First of all, I gotta make sure it's closed tight. Someone on the other side. There is a fake light switch that goes in the back of the third bookshelf. Pull an elk, reach back, there is a ring to pull to open it. That takes you right over to the wine cellar. All right, now, change up here. Third way to open it, it was electric, battery operated. There are two copper screws on the side of the fireplace mantle. Take a coin, complete the circuit, and pop the door open. All right, we're gonna go out into the tennis courts. That door went to a shower room changing area for the grass tennis courts. That door is sealed, there's a wall on the other side of it now. And that room became our public restroom. So there's three toilets in each room if anyone needs a bathroom. There's only one in the gift shop. And you know what the bathroom situation is on the tour boat. All right, I'm going to come back and shut that.
Passageway. Canadian side of Lake Ontario.
Rifle talk.
Cool. Well, thank you very much, Maddie and Zoe.
Of course.
My name is Ben, and I will be demonstrating the use of the Brunswick Percussion Cap Rifle. This is the battle weapon of the Royal Canadian Rifle Regiment, whose uniform I'm wearing, and we're a bit like the Special Forces of the 1840s. We had special roles in battle, in a pitch battle with two armies facing off against one another. We would be skirmishers, we would be sharpshooters, we would go out in front of that line of battle, and we would target enemy officers. We would target enemy musicians because they transmit the officers' commands to the men over the sound of battle. And we would target powder monkeys, who were people who brought up the black powder to the line of fighting. We could also act as a light company, which means we could split up into squads of two or four and make our way through the woods and fight our way through broken or wooded terrain. This is a special weapon. It has a much longer range than the muskets, and it is much more accurate because it actually has a true, it is a true rifle. It has rifling down the barrel, which means the ball comes out and it spins. It's like throwing a football in a spiral rather than throwing it end over end. I'm gonna fire two shots today. I'm gonna stand out where that sign is behind me. I'm gonna make two concessions for modern safety. I'm gonna wear my eye protection, and I have my ear protection. Maddie is our range officer today, so she is responsible for everybody's safety during the demonstration. Where you're all seated is good, but she will let you know if you're somewhere you shouldn't be standing. And my colleague Kieran down there, he's going to be yelling the traditional commands at me here. Is there anything I'm forgetting? And Zoe's also going to be doing some interpretation. I was someone I was forgetting. Is there anything that I'm forgetting or that you guys would like to add? No? All right. I will hand over control to our range officer, and we'll get started.
All righty.
This is about 300 to 400 yards, actually. Whereas a musket has about a maximum range of about 150, but really you want to be about 75 to 100 yards because it's not very accurate.
Yeah, we're ready to go. All righty. Alrighty, so I'm just going to be letting you guys know a little bit about what Ben's doing with each step so that you can get a better insight to how loading and firing the rifle works. So as Kieran yells each command, I'll explain what's happening with each one for you. So a fun fact I always like to add is, although the riflemen historically wouldn't have had the same nice earplugs that Ben gets to wear, a lot of the soldiers would take little pieces of cotton and put those in their ears to help dampen the noise from the weapons. So if you've ever heard the phrase, get the cotton out of your ears, that's where that comes from.
Prepare to load!
So right now, Ben is going to brace the rifle between his legs, and he's going to reach into his cartouche, which is that leather bag on his back, and he's going to grab out his black powder cartridge. And once his hand is out behind him, that means he's ready for the next command.
Load!
Now Ben is showing one of the only requirements to be in the British military, and that was to have two teeth, one on the top and one on the bottom, to bite down on the cartridge and rip it open.
Run! Home! Return! Gap!
So the process Ben just went through would have been the longest historically, as that's whenever Ben would have had to actually hammer the belted ball that would have been fired out of the rifle down the barrel with a mallet and that ramrod you saw him use. However, it's the fastest for us here because we don't actually fire any propellant.
Make ready!
On the next command, Ben will fire the rifle if you want to get your cameras out for a picture or plug your ears. Now is your time to do so. So what's happened here actually is historically accurate. This is something called a misfire. So black powder is a very finicky substance, and oftentimes if it's too humid outside or wet and the black powder gets damp in any way, it'll stick to the side of the barrel and it won't fire properly. So now what Ben is going to do is he's going to replace the percussion cap that we use in order to ignite the spark to fire the rifle. And he's going to replace that and try one more time.
Reset!
All right, so misfire one more time. Ben has one more shot in order to go again. You're going to notice he's going to hold this position for a little bit, though, and he's going to hold it for 10 seconds to make sure that there isn't something called a hang fire, which is sometimes the black powder just won't go off right away, but then in a few seconds it'll have like a delayed fire afterwards. So that's why he holds the positions for a little bit after each misfire. A fun fact I always like to throw in is that the Battle of Waterloo was actually delayed for 3 days because it was raining, so none of them could fire their weapons.
Yay!
Load and fire on your time!
So now Ben is going to load and fire the weapon one more time, this time without Kieran yelling any of the commands for him. This is what it would look like more or less historically on the battlefield, as the officer wouldn't have yelled each individual command each time for the men. A skilled rifleman historically could load and fire his weapon in about 1 minute or so. Here at Fort Wellington, though, our record time, I believe, is 17 seconds. All right, he's gonna fire. Beautiful. All right, let's give Ben a big round of applause.
Yay!